is provides us with a lot of information. The main problem is that people are not spending the time to see what information we have. And the literature has gotten clouded by the fact that other studies have been done using other conditions where you get different results, which of course is exactly what you expect. And so it's a question of interpretation, at least as much as a question of, you know, what research has been done. Yes, we do. Wi-Fi has been shown to cause 7 different health effects, and in repeated studies, and these are the same health effects that are produced by other kinds of electromagnetic fields, and they include oxidative stress, they include attacks on the DNA of our cells, they include many different effects on reproduction, both male fertility, female fertility, production of increased spontaneous abortions, including lowered sex hormones, including lowered libido. And all those things are impacted. But then, in addition, we have many different neurological and neuropsychiatric effects, which tend to develop over time in a cumulative fashion. Several other things have been shown to be occurring as well, including apoptosis, that is cell death of the cells of our bodies. I think Wi-Fi in schools is a huge mistake, because we can do the same things in terms of internet connection in a wired fashion and not jeopardize the health of our children and our teachers, which we are currently doing now in each of the ways that I just discussed and also in some other ways. So Wi-Fi is a big problem, and it's been a huge blunder to introduce Wi-Fi in schools. Yes, young children are more sensitive, and they're more sensitive for several different reasons. One is they have a larger surface-to-volume ratio, that is, their tissues are more accessible to the EMFs, and so you get bigger effects because of that. A second thing is that young children, the younger the child, the more stem cells they have, and stem cells are particularly sensitive to the EMFs. So the effects on young children, therefore, are much greater. And in general, you know, throughout development, the younger you are, the more stem cells you have, and the more sensitive you are. There are also effects with regard to the development of the brain, which are particularly important in young children, of course. It's been known. The first review that was published on pulsation that showed that pulsed EMFs are much more active in our bodies than our non-pulsed EMFs. This was published back in 1965. And there have been a whole slew of studies, you know, of course, many, many, many others since then. And so this is extensively documented. We know that pulsed EMFs are, in most cases, much more dangerous than our non-pulsed EMFs. So the reason that the industry has gone to these extremely high frequencies in 5G is because you can pulse them more, and therefore you can carry more information. And so because of that, 5G is at least potentially much more dangerous than the precursors for 5G because of this extraordinarily high levels of pulsation. The other thing is that the plan is that 5G is going to use a phased array system, which introduces an additional type of pulsation into our exposures. So all of those things mean that 5G is at least potentially much more dangerous than its precursors, and it needs to be tested and it has not been tested with the pulsations that are going to be used. So smartphones and cell phones in general, you know, can be used more safely. Probably headsets are the best way to do this. If you can't use a headset, you can use them on speakerphone. That's better because they're further away from the body. But there are many other ways that one can handle these things, so they're much safer. I mean, when you carry these phones on your body, you're being irradiated all the time, despite the fact you may not be using the phone at that time. They should not be carried on the body. You can buy pouches where one side of the pouch acts as a barrier to the EMFs. And if you wear it with that side towards your body, then of course you're protecting your body. So that can be a useful thing. But in general, people handle these things like they were toys, as if they had no health consequences, whereas in fact they do have major health consequences, and we need to pay attention to them. Oh, there are many, many possibilities. And the problem is that, of course, it takes work to do, you know, to avoid all the different exposures. I mean, you shouldn't have your cell phone and your cordless phones in your bedroom, for example. I don't think you should have them at all myself. I don't have either one. But you know, but certainly, you know, having them near you when you're sleeping is a big mistake. But they also have impacts, you know, when you're awake and during the day. So you want to minimize these as much as you can. But those aren't the only sources of exposure. We've got so many different exposures that, you know, it's extraordinarily difficult to avoid all of them. And of course, the industry seems to be intent on making it more and more difficult for us to avoid exposures. You know, every day introducing new devices and more highly powered devices. I mean, for example, the Wi-Fi fields, most of them today are much, much more highly powered than they used to be. And they're much more dangerous. So we're going in exactly the wrong direction. You know, so there's a lot of ways you can try to avoid exposures, but it's, you know, I mean, it's ridiculous that we're in an environment where you have to be an expert on all this stuff just in order to have just the minimum amount of protection to your health. But that's the situation. Yes, we do. In the risk assessment, and let me give you an example of that, which is current as we speak. The current plan with regard to 5G is to put out tens of millions of 5G antennae all over the EU, all over the US, all over many other parts of the world, such that we will be irradiated almost continuously no matter where we go. And the current plan is to do that without even a single biological safety test of genuine 5G radiation. This is absolutely insane. This is absolutely insane. So yes, we have to work on our politicians, and in the EU, we have to work on the European Commission, because if they go ahead with this, this will be, in my judgment, absolute disaster. And I think, it's just stupid beyond belief that something like that could even be contemplated, let alone done.